west. After which, the hemisphere being serene, about an hour before sunset, a ship with like dimensions, with the aforesaid, with her canvas and colors abroad, though the wind northerly, appeared in the air, coming from our harbor's mouth, which lies southward from the town, seemingly with her sails filled under a fresh gale, holding her course north and continuing under observation, sailing against the wind for the space of half an hour.
And at last their prayers were answered. It was in the month of June, and an hour before the sunset of a windy afternoon, when steadily steering landward, a ship was seen below, and they knew it was Lamberton Master who sailed so long ago. On she came with a cloud of canvas, right against the wind she blew, until the eye could distinguish the faces of the crew. Then fell her straining topmast, hanging tangled in the shrouds, and her sails were loosened and lifted and blown away by clouds. The masts with all their rigging fell slowly one by one, and the hulk dilated and vanished as a sea mist in the sun.
Many were drawn to behold this great work of God. Yea, the very children cried out, there's a brave ship. At length, crowding up as far as there is usually water sufficient for such a vessel, and so near, saw the spectators, as they imagined, a man might hurl a stone on board her. Her main top seemed to be blown off, but left hanging in the shrouds. Then her mizzen top, then all her masting seemed blown away by the board. Quickly, after the halt brought to a careen, she overset and so vanished into a smoky cloud, which in some time dissipated, leaving as everywhere else a clear air.
And the people who saw this marvel, each said unto his friend that this was the mold of their vessel, and thus her tragic end. And the pastor of the village gave thanks to God in prayer, that to quiet their troubled spirits, he had sent this ship of air.
The admiring spectators could distinguish the several colors of each part, the principal rigging, and such proportions, as caused only the generality of persons to say, this was the mold of their ship, and this was their tragic end. But Mr. Davenport, also in public, declared to this effect that God had condescended. For the quieting of their afflicted spirit, this extraordinary account of his sovereign disposal of those for whom so many fervent prayers were made continually.
Rocked in the cradle of the deep, I lay me down in peaceful sleep. Secure I rest upon the wave, for thou, O Lord, hath power to save. I know thou wilt not shout my call, for thou dost make the sparrow fall.
And calm and peaceful is my sleep, rocked in the cradle of
were mine, though stormy winds blew o'er the brine, and though the tempest's fiery breath roused me from sleep to wreck and death, in ocean's cave still safe with thee, the germ of immortality.
And calm and peaceful is my sleep, rocked in the cradle of the deep. And calm and peaceful is my sleep, rocked in the cradle of the deep.
took them to accept to do this. We don't want to do that. That's embarrassing.
Sure, so I'm not sure where she went.